Hello everyone, my name is Riipley and today we're building a little cottage in Windenburg. Of course this is because Cottage Living is just about to come out. It's about a week left and I'm so excited. So I wanted to build something cottage inspired and I think that Windenburg is a really good place to do that. Not only because of the style, like I really like this European kind of German style, and I think that a lot of things that comes with the get together pack, which of course Windenburg comes in that pack, and I think that a lot of the style and items in that pack really fits that kind of cottage vibe that I'm going for. So we are building this in Windenburg, as I said, and the outside ended up being mainly get together and base game, and I was really proud of myself for that. But then of course as we moved inside and did the furnishing, I quite quickly ended up using a lot more packs, so it's a little bit more packs than I originally intended it to be, but I think it ended up looking really really nice. I also have a base game cottage that's coming out on Wednesday, I believe, because this should come up on Sunday. So on Wednesday I have a base game cottage for you that I really really love how that turned out. So if you, I know that a lot of people don't have many packs or any packs, so this might not be for everyone and I totally get that and that's fine, but I do have a base game one as well, which is already out on my gallery if you're interested. But like I said, that video will be on Wednesday, so make sure to check that out when it comes out. Yeah, but yeah, like I said, this is built in Windenburg and we built this on the lot that had a kind of annoying wall on the backside. You know, if you have ever built on this lot, you know that you kind of always get like jumped up on that wall on the backside, so it's kind of hard to see what I'm doing on the back. But I think that with what I had, I think it ended up looking really really good. So this house is a two-bedroom house. It's a master bedroom and a kid's bedroom, so it fits three themes. On the downstairs I have the kitchen and living area and the half bath, and upstairs is the living room, the two bedrooms and the full bath. So it's a smaller house, but I really like the way that it ended up looking and I really like the size. I don't think that I would have wanted it to be any bigger or smaller for that matter. I think that this is kind of the perfect size for what I was doing. And now we're jumping on to the lens, and the terrain paint was so annoying to work with when I built this. I don't know what it is, I don't know if it's a bug or if I'm doing something, but sometimes when I put the terrain paint down and I'm finished, it just kind of randomly disappears. It's not necessarily that I am doing anything. Sometimes I'm like messing around trying to pick a terrain paint and then everything else just disappears for some reason and I don't really know what's going on with that. You have to let me know if you have the same issue, but it's super annoying. And it's like, I think I redid the terrain paint like 3 or 4 times, which is not fun, especially, you know, if you do it for a long time and you just kind of get it right, and then when you like really like how it turned out, it disappears and it's like no way to get it back either. You have to start over, which is super super annoying. So let me know if you have that issue as well. I don't know, because I don't think it should be like a mod problem or anything like that. So yeah, I don't know why that is. But during the landscaping, I really liked how the landscaping ended up turning out. I did struggle a little bit with it because I feel like I'm doing kind of the same thing over and over again right now, and I just want to do something different, but I don't really know really what to do. And I think that the landscaping here is kind of similar to how I've been doing it for the last few videos. So I really want to look to mix it up more, but if you have any landscaping tips, then make sure to leave them in the comments. I would really appreciate that. And then I had this little nook behind the stairs on the outside, and I put the fireplace there. I don't know how useful it would be. I think that still would count as like warming your Sims up during the winter, even if it is outside, but I'm not quite sure. I guess it's more decoration, all your stuff kind of fill out that space, and I think that it looked really really nice. And we had the stash on the back as well, which does lead up to the upstairs floor, but we do also have interior stash, which I thought was important because we are in Windenburg. Have you been in like a world like Oasis Springs or Strangerville? But perhaps we wouldn't really have to worry about that because the climate in those worlds are more like warm, the winters don't get cold, it's not raining that much. So for those worlds, I might not have an interior staircase, but because we're in Windenburg, it's like an European inspired world. It's gonna be a lot of snow and a lot of rain, and you don't want to seem to, like, even realistically, you wouldn't want to go outside in the middle of a snowstorm or rainstorm or whatever. So I thought that for the place that we are building in, an interior staircase was essential. So, but I really liked the kind of visual interesting aspect with having exterior stairs as well. I have really been working a lot with making my builds more like visually interesting, and I think that that is one thing that kind of helps with that, because otherwise this build is just like a box with another box on top of it and then like a smaller box on the side, and it's not super interesting. But I think that the stairs on one side, and as well just having that kind of part, a big part of the upstairs is kind of just being supported by columns, I think that makes it more interesting, as well as with kind of the landscaping around it kind of makes it look more like I said, visually interesting. It's not just a shoebox, right? And then I added in some plants and stuff on the exterior. I really like this kind of area where the front door is, and you have like your picnic, what is it called? Not a picnic table, like a picnic bench, I think, and like some planters and plant boxes and like a lot of like plants and flowers. And I would kind of imagine that maybe whoever lives here really like the like are into the gardening and planting and that kind of stuff. And then in the kitchen I ended up using this country kitchen set, which I thought really fit in. I really like the style of the country kitchen set, and I think it really fits into the cottage vibe that I'm going for. So I think it ended up looking really, really nice. I'm also using the cats and dogs wallpaper here. I really like that blue siding with the light walls. I don't use this wallpaper that often, mainly because I usually build modern, but I really think it looked really pretty in this house. And also I think it complements the Jungle Adventure flooring really well as well. So I used a lot of the country kitchen stuff in this build just to decorate. Like I said, I think it really fits into this world and this kind of style that we're going for, as well as having a small dining table in that little like nook between the stairs and the bathroom. And I think that that was really the only place where the dining table would fit. We could have put it by the front door, but I didn't want it to be too like cluttered at the front door. I think it's nice to have some open space where you walk in. So by the front door I only did like a place to put your shoes, a place to put your jacket and that kind of stuff, but not too much. I didn't want to clutter this space up too much. Like I said, you still want it to be kind of open. You don't want it to be very like tight, and you don't want to feel like you're walking into everything as fast as you go into the front door, right? If that makes sense. And then, like I usually do, I didn't film me doing the bathrooms because it's just extra time, and I think that the bathrooms always look the same, right? So I didn't do the bathrooms, but downstairs is a half bath and upstairs is a full bath. So upstairs we have a shower, while downstairs is just a sink and a toilet. And in the living room up here, I reused the paranormal couches and armchair. I really love them. I think they look really pretty, and they really fit into the vibe that I was going for, as well as that it's a desk. It's called a desk, the paranormal desk. I really like that. I never really get to use this because it was stylized, but I thought that it would fit into this build. And of course I put it in a computer as well, because it's always important to have a computer as well as a TV. I don't actually think I have like an easel or anything in here, but I do have a bookcase. So yeah, I think I got all the essentials that you need. And I'm just adding in some few little details here and there. We had this little hallway space where you come up with the both of the stairs, but it's not really much to decorate. I just put in like a painting and call it a day. Didn't really need more than that. And then we're gonna move on to the parents' bedroom, which I really, really like how that turned out. I did kind of struggle with finding a bed, but I actually really like the Seasons one that I used, which is kind of a surprise for me. I have been using it for an apartment build I did recently, and now this build, and I usually, before I didn't like it when it came out, I hated that bed, I think I said in my last video that I used it, that I thought it looked like a camping bed, but I really think it fit into this build, and I'm actually starting to like it more and more. So that's a surprise for me. I didn't think that I would ever like this bed, but I really like how it looked with like the wallpaper and everything. I think it really fit in really well. And otherwise I just put in some like a dresser and some mirrors, nothing too fancy, just a simple bedroom really. Just adding in some frame lights and some rugs and that kind of stuff, and I think that it came together really really well. And then when we moved on to the kids' bedroom, the kids' bedroom is quite a funky shape. Like we have on both sides, on one side we had like this 1x1, and on the other side we had it like 1x2, and in the 1x2 I put in one of those like built-in wardrobes, but we still had that weird like 1x1 space, and I ended up putting, and that is mainly like covered by the bed, but I also put in a bookcase in there. The bookcase is not functional, but it just kind of serves as like a filling purpose, right? But with that said, we are about to jump in the screenshots, so if you like this video, make sure to like and subscribe. I have a lot of content on Cottage Living coming out soon, so if you are interested in that, make sure to subscribe as well for more like cottage and other Sims building stuff. And yeah, but I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you all very very soon. Riipley out. And whoa.